Hello friends, it's Kick, and in today's episode, we have OpenAI transforming ChatGPT into an AI search engine, ending Google's hegemony. Microsoft has released a chatbot for US intelligence services that works without an internet connection. Tesla has demonstrated new skills for the Optimus robot. Bionic B-sized robots capable of flying in swarms. EHang, which conducted the first passenger flight of an air taxi in the UAE. A Chinese automotive giant has introduced the first mass-produced electric transformer car, and SpaceX has shown a new spacesuit for extravehicular activity. All this and much more right now. Let's go. Well, it has happened. OpenAI has announced the development of an internet search function for ChatGPT, which will provide an expanded response to queries with links to sources. This will allow users to search for the information they need and see supporting materials immediately. The new functionality will enable OpenAI to begin direct competition with Google. The new feature will allow users to receive answers in which internet information is accompanied by links to sources such as articles from Wikipedia or blog posts. One version of the product will complement text answers with relevant images. For example, if a user needs to know how to change a door handle, the answer may include a diagram or an image with step-by-step instructions. The competition in the field of artificial intelligence is intensifying, and OpenAI is looking to expand the capabilities of ChatGPT. Startup Perplexity has already achieved significant success with its search engine, which emphasizes accuracy and citability, and has been valued at $1 billion. Google is also actively developing new AI features for its search engine and plans to reveal the prospects of the Gemini algorithms at the I/O conference. And here's Microsoft presenting a generative artificial intelligence model based on GPT-4, specially developed for American intelligence services, that operates without an internet connection. The new artificial intelligence model meets the growing interest of intelligence services in the use of generative AI for processing classified information, while reducing the risks of data leaks or hacking attacks. Microsoft has a license to use GPT, as it has invested $10 billion in OpenAI. ChatGPT operates on Microsoft's cloud servers, which could lead to data leaks and interception. Last year, the CIA announced plans to create its own service similar to ChatGPT, but the Microsoft project is reported to be a separate initiative. The development of the new system took 18 months. During the process, engineers modified a supercomputer with artificial intelligence located in Iowa. The new service was activated last week and is now available to about 10,000 members of the intelligence community for further testing. Amid the first demonstrations of humanoid robots Optimus, where real prototypes were held on a stand and the ability to dance was provided by a person dressed as a robot, subsequent videos from Tesla demonstrated progress, but the feeling of rawness of the product remained. In the new video, the company showed how it trains Optimus robots to perform useful work on the assembly line. One such operation was the placement of cylindrical battery cells type 4680 into a special container, structurally reminiscent of an egg carton. In the new video, the Optimus robot receives the incoming battery cells via a chute and places them into containers. Subtitles narrate that such manipulations are enabled by a neural network trained simply from images from two-dimensional cameras. The video also demonstrates the setting in which several robots are trained simultaneously. Each has an operator who looks at the sorted items through a kind of augmented reality helmet, and also allows electronics to read data about manipulations using sensors worn on the arm. Essentially, during the training phase, the robots should gain the ability to perform similar manipulations independently. Tesla notes that additional attention is given to the robot's ability to maintain balance during all manipulations. At the end of the video, Optimus is shown circling arbitrarily around the laboratory space. This is done, of course, for training purposes, and with each time the robot is able to travel further and further without outside help. Tesla representatives noted in the video comments that they are currently trying to make Optimus robots move faster and travel not only on flat surfaces but also over more complex terrain. Elon Musk recently promised to start using Optimus robots at Tesla's facilities by the end of this year, and by the end of next year to offer them to external customers. And since we've started talking about robots, let's continue with them. The German company Festo has announced the creation of a flying robot resembling a bee. Like ordinary bees, the robobees have learned to fly in swarms without colliding with each other or with obstacles. The company believes that work on such projects will bring a lot of new developments to robotics and allow for the adoption of many working solutions from nature. Festo's main activity is the production of industrial equipment. About 15 years ago, the company's project division began studying and creating bionic mechanisms. The developer's assets include a robot robot ant, robot dragonfly, robot butterfly, robot spider, flying fox, which we have already shown you. Based on these mechanisms, engineers studied and adapted the features of movement and flight of living creatures. The RoboBee Bionic Bee became the latest development, in which for the first time, a mechanism of flight in a swarm was implemented. The design of the RoboBee Bionic Bee in the form of an ornithopter with two flapping wings was helped by, of course, AI. Where would we be without it these days? As a result, the construction was made as light as possible. The weight of the Bionic Bee is 34 grams with a body length of 22 centimeters and a wingspan of 24 centimeters. The flapping frequency can vary from 15 to 20 times per second. This work is performed by a brushless electric motor. Separately, three servo motors at the base of each wing change their geometry to create lift at the right time and place. The system of flight for the robot bees in a swarm is based on a system of broadband beacons. In a special room, two levels of beacons are installed, by the timestamps of which the robot bees determine their position in space and in the swarm. The system takes into account many factors, including turbulence from the wing flaps of neighbors in the swarm. For Festo engineers, this was a valuable experience in creating a robotic flying unit and organizing coordinated flight of a group of such units. Someday, this experience will be useful for developing even more advanced bionic and swarming automatons. Let's move on. The Chinese auto giant Changan Automobile has introduced a new line of serial electric cars that debuted at the International Auto Show in Beijing. The transformer electric car Nivo E-Aero 7 incorporates features of both a pickup and an SUV. According to Changan Automobile, Nivo E-Aero 7 has the off-road capability and can transform into a full-fledged pickup. The sloping roof can be moved by an electric drive, providing access to the luggage compartment. The tailgate then lowers, turning the electric car into a pickup. In Beijing, it was presented with a four-seater cabin layout. A large central screen with an adjustable tilt angle is used to control the cabin. Nivo E07 is based on the SDA platform developed by Changan Automobile. The company places great hopes on it, calling SDA a full-fledged digital ecosystem with connection to 5G networks. An electric motor with a power of 343 horsepower will provide a maximum speed of up to 201 km/h. The all-wheel drive version of E07 involves the use of a pair of synchronous motors with a total power of 598 horsepower. The cost of the new product is not yet known. Now let's go up into the sky. The unmanned electric vertical takeoff and landing aircraft EH216S made a demonstration flight with a passenger on board in Abu Dhabi. This is the first such case in the UAE and the Middle East. In addition, two new modifications of the electric aircraft, EH216F for extinguishing fires at high altitude facilities and EH216L for air logistics, also made their first flights in the UAE. EH216S made a flight in unmanned mode at the DriftX event in Abu Dhabi. During the second flight in early May, Multilevel Group board member Mohamed Al-Dahiri was on board as a passenger. This company is one of the partners and investors of EHang in the UAE, which helps develop ground infrastructure for future aircraft operations. UAE authorities plan to launch the operation of flying taxis in 2026. Currently, relevant regulators are conducting all necessary consultations with Chinese colleagues. And what would kick be without space? SpaceX introduced a suit for extravehicular activities and extravehicular activities. It is significantly different from the usual bulky and uncomfortable suits with large helmets. The SpaceX suit is called EVA, Extravehicular Activity Spacesuit, or Suit for Extravehicular Activity. It was created with an emphasis on the mobility of astronauts, so they can move both inside and outside the SpaceX Dragon capsule. Therefore, the suit has specially designed areas where the fabric needs to bend and not hinder the person's movement. There is also a module for connecting the suit to the ship. It houses submodules for communication, cooling system, and pressure control. The latter is regulated by a system of valves. The suit is also made with the consideration that it can be easily tailored to any body type. The EVA helmet is 3D printed and has special niches for a microphone and pressure adjustment valves. There is also a camera and a special display to expand the field of vision and display important information, such as the pressure level inside the suit, temperature, and humidity. In addition, the helmet reduces glare from the sun when going out into open space. The suit is made of fire-resistant materials, mainly Teflon fabric and Nomex. Teflon fabric consists of thin glass threads coated with Teflon. As a result, it does not melt at temperatures up to 650 degrees. Nomex is used to make firefighters' clothing. It consists of aramid polymers and resembles Kevlar. SpaceX did not disclose how much the EVA will cost, but it is known that the cost of a NASA suit is more than $1 million. The National Space Administration of China has presented the concept of its lunar base. It features a landing module and a rover, as well as a launch pad for orbital satellites. The agency intends to invest in this project over the next few decades. By 2028, the agency plans to launch the first communications designed for power production, as well as other infrastructure facilities. The project involves the construction of the International Lunar Research Base, where research will be conducted. The complex will be adapted for long-term missions on the surface of the satellite, as well as in its orbit. It is planned that ELRs will be built in two stages. By 2035, key infrastructure facilities will be built around the southern pole of the moon, and by 2045, a fully equipped complex will be built. And that's all for today. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell to stay updated on high-tech news. Peace to your home.